Bryan Kohberger, unalive others. These are other unsolved cases that are similar to what happened to the Idaho 4. All attacks happened on the 13th of the month, and all the victims were sleeping. No arrests have been made in the following cases.
In a developing story tonight, there is now a reward out to find the person who killed a Washougal grandmother. She was found dead in her home 4 months ago, and there are still no arrests in the case. Mike Benner spoke with a longtime friend and colleague of Sandra Ladd, who's hoping for justice.
Washougal's still a very good story, and these kind of things just come.
The sort of thing Lester Brown is talking about is the murder of his longtime colleague and friend, Sandra Ladd.
Her passing is just a really huge shock to all of us.
The 71-year-old Ladd was found dead inside her home on 41st Street in Washougal back in mid-June.
In a tearful plea to the community, the family of a homicide victim asking for anyone who knows what happened to please come forward.
Someone violently attacked the Hijutin family in the middle of the night last year, and family friends say the actions saved his wife's life. Liz Birch joined us now in the studio. Liz, they're desperate for answers here.
They really are. That reward is up to $50,000 for information. They say it's made up of donations, and it makes them hopeful someone will come forward.
Nothing justifies this horrific crime.
With the Marion County Courthouse behind her, Travis Jutton's mother, Myra, begged the community to help her get justice for her son. She shared fond memories of Travis nearly a year after he was killed.
He was the most kind, sweet, smart child you ever would want. Throughout his life, Travis brought us so much joy and happiness.
She says her grief has gotten worse every day since the news that her son died.
I never understood what a broken heart felt like until that morning of August 13th, 2021. A monster or monster decided that their life was more important than our son.
Investigators say in August of last year, an intruder came into Travis Jutton's rural Marion County home in the middle of the night, stabbing and killing Travis and wounding his wife, Jamie Lynn. The details are gruesome. At the time, a family friend told Coyne Travis was killed while trying to fight off the intruder and said Jamie Lynn was stabbed a total of 19 times. I asked the Marion County Sheriff's Office today if there are any updates in the investigation. They say they haven't made any arrests. They're still looking for information. Travis's mother begged anyone who knows who did this to come forward.
Every day the grief gets worse as we have no answers. Somebody knows something. So I'm begging you as Travis's mother, whose heart breaks every day, to reach out to Detective Van Horn with any information you may have, no matter what it might be. Please be that hero I know that's out there.
And then there's a third case. Charleston police are searching for the person responsible for stabbing someone while they slept. They say it happened before 3 a.m. on June 13, 2021. In the 1500 block of Edgar Drive. The suspect, most likely known to the victim, entered the home and attacked them while they slept. The victim was able to get to a neighbor and contact emergency responders. They were later treated and released. Charleston police are asking for help from the community to identify the suspect. Anyone with information is asked to call 217-345-8402 or 866-345-8488. Let's go over what Heavy.com said in their article on Sandra Ladd. Sandra was a resident of Washougal, Washington, and a former school secretary who was stabbed to death inside her home in 2020. The unsolved murder of Sandra Ladd is back in the news after the knife attack that killed four other college students from the University of Idaho. No connection has been found at this point. However, there are similarities between Ladd's homicide and the way the college student died in Moscow. In addition, the stabbings of a couple, Travis and Jamie Lynn Jutin, in Marion County, Oregon, bear some of the similarities to the Moscow homicides. And then there's Travis Juton. He was a resident of Marion County, Oregon. He was stabbed to death by a masked man who attacked him as Juton slept in his home. And Travis Juton's murder, which occurred in a rural area near Salem, Oregon, remains unsolved. His wife, Jamie Lynn Juton, was also stabbed multiple times during the attack, but she survived. The home is technically in Silverton, Oregon. The slaying occurred on August 13, 2021. The unsolved murder of Travis Juton is back in the news after the knife attack in Idaho. They say no connection has been found at this point. However, there are similarities between Juton's homicide and the way the college students died in Moscow on November 13, 2022. It's just strange that there's other stabbings that have been unsolved up to this point. And that brings us back to this monster, Bryan Kohberger. He's the suspect in the University of Idaho students who were killed in Moscow, Idaho, while they slept. Their crime occurred also on the 13th, but theirs was the 13th of November, 2022. Kohlberg, who is 28 years old, and was arrested on December 30th in Pennsylvania, where he grew up. Kohlberg is facing extradition to Idaho on murder charges, which his attorney has said they have waived extradition. His attorney says Mr. Kohlberg is eager to be exonerated of these charges and looks forward to resolving these matters as promptly as possible, is what he told CNN. The attorney also said his father actually went out to Idaho and they drove home together. The lawyer told CNN that he has spoken with Kohlberger's family and they're also very shocked, calling the accusations out of character for Bryan. Bryan's full name is Bryan Christopher Kohberger. According to the FBI, Pennsylvania State Police, and the Moscow Police Department, they tracked Kohberger and located him in Chestnut Hill Township in Monroe County in Pennsylvania in the Pocono Mountains. The warrant accuses Kohberger of first-degree murder. Bill Thompson, the lead prosecutor in the Lataw County, Idaho, said at the news conference that Kohberger was charged with 4 counts of first-degree murder and felony burglary. He said the probable cause affidavit with additional details will be sealed until Kohberger has appeared in an Idaho courtroom. Kohberger, who is being held without bond, has an apartment in Pullman, Thompson said at the news conference. Thompson also said Kohberger's next day in court will be on January 3rd, 2023 at 3:30. And he is being represented by a public defender. So we all know Kohberger is pursuing his PhD in criminal justice and criminology. As a psychology graduate student at DeSales University in Pennsylvania, he was a student investigator for a survey that explored people's actions, thoughts, and feelings when they committed crimes. One question in the study was, Why did you choose the victim or target over others? Another question reads, after committing the crime, what were you thinking and feeling? This is very strange questions. So we'll have to wait and see if these three cases come back to Bryan Kohberger as the culprit. Law enforcement in all three cases have evidence. So we'll see if he's linked to these. I just find it awful strange that these three cases, these victims, were all stabbed while they slept on the 13th of the month at approximately 3 a.m. in the morning. We'll keep following this case. And until next time, you guys.
Caution. Crime is hot. Caution. Crime is hot. Caution. Crime is hot. Caution. Crime is hot.